Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Singapore, the fantastic skyline of Singapore, the Merlion, and right across from there is the sports hub, the fantastic new facilities here, the OCBC Arena. It's Hall 1, and it's the Mission Foods Nations Cup 2016 version. We've got a really good crowd inside the arena right now for the third and fourth placing. Nobody here in the host wanted to hear the third, fourth placing, but I'm afraid that's the way it is. These are the six nations involved. Ireland played Canada and were victorious. And it's now Botswana versus Singapore for the third and fourth placing in this year's edition of the Nations Cup. It'll be Zambia, Papua New Guinea to follow that, but in the moment our focus is very much on the court there. Singapore on the right of screen in the all red, and it will be a fabulous matchup, I know, because I'm joined by Pearline Chan, four years the captain of the Singapore national squad, and in fact was a winner here back in the day when Singapore won in 2007 and in six, I believe, as well.
Yes, John, that's the two fantastic years. So we have the third and fourth placing match, Botswana versus Singapore. It's going to be exciting. I can't wait for the match to start.
You, and I think certainly a lot of the crowd here as well. It's a very popular sport, netball, in Singapore, and there's a big crowd here. They're really, really enjoying the prospect of this one. They lost the last time out they played in the second day of competition. It was a very, very close encounter, ultimately 42-38. And the crowd here really looking forward to this. They think that Singapore can get revenge. How can they do that, though, Pearline? It's going to be a big, big issue here, because Hilda Binang, she's at the top there, the goal shooter, has got a fantastic record. 90% of her shots on goal have been successful. That's amazing.
Yeah, that's one of Singapore's strategy would have to be to stop the both goal shooter and goal attack, because they're really accurate under the post.
But of course, with Singapore's very experienced team, they've actually lost a few defenders over this last year, certainly from the last time I saw them. Still, we've got Charmaine So up there at the top of the tree. And Pamela actually has not been performing as regularly and as well consistently in the percentage stakes as we had hoped for. But there's a lot at stake here, isn't there? I'm not going to battle against the stadium announcer, so I'll let her do her business. There's Charmaine, there's Pamela. Only 61% for Pamela.
Yeah. Sorry, John. For Singapore to compete well today, they have to start really well. And then we need both the goal shooter, Charmaine, and Pamela to be shooting, you know, at a fairly high percentage, because simply because Botswana is such an accurate team.
All the substitutes coming in now. We saw the very tall Chun Li Lee, the goalkeeper, just before this. A lot will depend on whether or not she can control Binang. Hilda Binang. And we'll see her in a while as well. There's Ruth Aitken. Ruth Aitken, the coach, with Chung Li Li. The whole squad, actually. Huang Po Chin and Chang Rong Chun. Ung Chun Ti. Here's the girl that will be between third and fourth place, I believe. Hilda Binang. Control her and you've got a chance. Chetsa Shelamitsi is the wing attack. She is. She's diminutive, but she's so fast.
Goalkeeper and vice captain, Lee Tae Bo Hang, Mok Naka Lesso.
So the formal side of proceedings complete, and we now look to the real meat of the moment, and it will be a big challenge for Singapore to make amends for their defeat on day two of the competition, where they lost it 42-38. It was a close affair, but the big difference was under the net, where you have to say Hilda Binang was quite superb. And off colour a little bit was Pamela Liu. So we'll just see whether or not Singapore now can start well. They've got possession is with Botswana to start. Let's see whether they can turn this one over.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be one of those energetic affairs. I mean, both sides will want to start fast and settle in quickly for the game.
Botswana make the first point. And again, they're not that tall under the basket, certainly compared with Chun Li Lee, but they have an extraordinary record of consistency. Already you can see the difference between the movement in these teams and the previous matchup, but oh, there was a little mistake there, but and they haven't recovered. Turnover is there, and that will be very, very disappointing. Singapore have lost out there, and of course, it's all about the turnover and the possession.
It is. It's about minimizing your errors and then really capitalizing on any opportunity you get, which is basically what Botswana will be looking to do.
Watch out for Binang here, though. Hilda Binang, well, it's going to be left, and it will come over across to Bagidi. Bagidi makes it. She's the captain. She looks pretty coy in her photograph, but I tell you what, she is an aggressive young lady. Well, there's a bit of aggression there as well.
Yeah, as well from Kimberly Lim. Yeah.
Oh, this is going to be a great start for Botswana. Singapore have really got to be watching out. They're trying to play man-to-man at the moment, or woman-to-woman, I suppose I should be saying. But it's all looking very, very good for Botswana to start. And it's, oh, there's a miss. And a good pickup. Nice work.
Good rebound by Captain Vanessa Lee. So Lee has been out and about for a while. And it's really good to see her back in the national setup.
You played with her. So from your day, what, 32? I think she's 32 now. Is that right, Vanessa? Yep, 32 years old. And 63 caps before this competition, so hugely experienced. She played in the invitational team, Singapore's invitational international team last year. But, obviously, been on the scene a long time. Just look at the fast passing. And here's Hilda up with the ball and in. She is absolutely Miss Dynamic and absolutely so consistent.
Yeah, Singapore will be looking to get on the board. You know, that would settle your nerves as well.
Yeah. Well, it's got to be Charmaine to take it for sure. There she goes. There she in.
Nice shot.
Well, they're smiling at the moment. Let's see if they're smiling at the end. We've only had a couple of minutes, three, 4 minutes gone. 3 minutes. That's a good turnover. Nice play. Oh, what defending that was. Wow.
Contest, John.
Fabulous. Great defending. This is really building up to be a fabulous contest. Oh, over the top, but that was an unfair advantage. Little contact. Singapore really got to do so well. There's Lily trying her best, but Hill is there with the ball once again, and it's in the net.
Chun Li Lee has been doing quite well throughout the week. You know, her distance has been good. Her lean is good. It's quite scary. I mean, having that long arms in your face. So she will have to do plenty of that this match just to contain Hilda.
She's just a smidgen under 2 meters in height. You know, 196 she is. So extraordinary. That's a good shot. 2-4. You can see how much it means to the crowd here. They're very fanatical in support. I Nice little touches here, and then getting into position, and Chun Li Lee's got to give way. She'll have to stand by the side, trying to put her big frame in a position to discomfort Hilda, but it ain't going to happen. Hilda Binang is just Miss Consistent. She might be Mrs. Consistent for all I know, but she's
but
certainly
she is
very
consistent.
Yeah, indeed. Got to move it. Ooh, close. Pamela puts it up for another big point. Just hear the crowd. 3-5. I love it the way that Charmaine actually applauds her own performance, don't you? She does it every time. It's great.
Yeah, it's quite funny to watch.
It is.
But then, you know, whatever works for her.
Yep. Yep, she doesn't applaud a miss, I have to say. So.
I wouldn't as well.
No. Right, Hilda's got the ball. She can go straight for goal. And just look at Chun Li Lee, puts her off. That's good stuff. But then, obviously, offends. Easy in for Tumisang Bagidi. Right, needs speed of attack here. Was that stepping or there was a nudge in the center, was it?
That was an offside by Kimberly Lim.
She touched her foot, probably.
Dear. So these are the little errors that you really want to cut out, especially when it's going to be a close affair. So good defense by Singapore, restricting the passes coming forward.
Lots of variety of attack, making each other available. Oh,
that's a short pass.
An error on the play there, round the circle. That won't do. Good bounce pass there. Nice. A way out, but look at this. Oh, super, super. Ho, ho. That is an absolute cracker of a shot. That was a really good turnover and then pick up beautifully.
And that's what you need your shooters to do, you know, reward you for every intercept.
That's out. It's out. It will be Singapore's ball. This is getting exciting. Next attack could be, I wonder who's got the centre pass after it.
I've lost track as well.
But this could be a very important moment. Singapore in this first quarter, getting back into this. Charmaine's already put down the marker. She's been dynamic underneath. Here's Pamela. Pamela needs to make it. Oh, and that's again a big, big error. Her confidence has gone a little bit. 61% in the previous matches. So that is really low. But look at that for a pick back. Excellent work. Now, there's the difference. She's not confident there, but it will be another little break and she can step forward on this. Not quite under the basket there, but again, Kimberly was... Pamela, rather, was in good position, but another good spot and make. And there, it was Singapore's ball after the goal.
So that's nice. That's a nice, quick passage of play.
Yeah, and excellent.
Well rewarded with a goal.
They were a little lucky to get away with repossessing a game, but having done that, here's another chance. Oh, unlucky. Hilda's on one foot. Doesn't matter. She could be standing on her head and still make it.
That's what I was going to say too.
Setuli. Mlotswa, oh yeah, good pick. Nurul needs to get in support. There she is, right there. Now we can see some form, some shape into this. Take one little step back. There you go. Now, Pamela, this time. Come on. Oi, oi. The net's caught up, but it wouldn't have made any difference. She's got... opportunity for Charmaine to put it through. Can we rescue the net? Come on, jump down and fix it.
I'll try my best, but it's going to be... You know, I'm not that great at jumping now.
Hilda passes it off. Bagidi is right there. She's underneath it. And that is, well, it would have counted. She'd have had another chance. But at 8-7, this is really tight. Singapore trying to go down the middle. It's no good.
Botswana is really fast on the counter-attacks.
Very.
So the Singapore defenders will really need to keep up with them.
Oh, no. That's outrageous. That's basketball stuff. Amazing. What a recovery. 9-7. Now they've got the chance to go three ahead, but that's a step out. Oi.
Bit pressure by the Singapore defense.
Yeah. Bagidi puts a foot out. Vanessa Lee again controlling things in the middle third at the moment. Good pass. That's really solid stuff. Look at this. Great work. Up for the... Oh, dear. Again, it's all about confidence, Pamela.
It is. And while, you know, her first three shots didn't make it through, she has to keep putting it up because very soon what the Botswanan defenders will do is they'll double on Charmaine and then that's one option down. So... she just have to keep putting it up.
Oh, that's the first error. First mistake from Hilda Benang. So Singapore reprieved after their mistakes. Charmaine moving. Well, okay, here's a chance here. Get this one in. You've got to play it. Get it in. Okay.
Well done, Pamela. And she fixed the net.
She fixed it. We didn't need you. This is the net. The next one, obviously, this attack could level things. Good shape. Looking for coming back off the play once more. Well, Pamela's got it. And misses again, my goodness. That's one from four now, is it? Or one from five? Unlucky. Some good aggression there, though. Yeah, and that could be Singapore's ball. It is.
So good work by Singapore defenders. They're really pressurizing every pass, and that's how the mistakes are coming in.
Oh, dear. Well, possession is everything. It's more than four-fifths of everything here. I tell you, the... Oh, is that some stepping?
That's a replay. So
replay.
She
she lost possession and then picked it up again. Yep. Okay. Goodness me. She's so difficult to play against. My goodness. Again, coming forward. That'll be good. That'll be Charmaine's chance here now. Makes it. Levels up at 9-all. And hear the crowd. It's serious stuff here. For the odd mistake that's made, they're making up for it, and there's another intercept. Great, great work.
Yeah, Vanessa Lee read it really well.
They are looking sharp, Singapore. There's a no-mistake attack here required. This for the lead. That will be a really big moment. And again, a hold on, so here's a chance now. Half a step. In it goes. 10-9.
And with a center pass to come.
Yep. Still Singapore's ball. Little lucky to get away with that. But here from distance. Oh, it's missed. But whose ball is that? No, I think that is Botswana's. Just a little over 1 minute left in the first quarter. It's gone like lightning this first quarter with so much action going on. It's so close. Much tighter, putting pressure on. Good passing. Hilda's there. This is for 10-all. Too easy. You get it to her. That's the ambition. If you get it to her, well... you're almost certain of completing the ambition of the score. Generally a little bit unlucky there, but Hilda's with the ball, takes half a pace, leaves it for Bagidi. She's got it on her own. This for the lead at 11-10. Love that hair. Oh, there's definitely some contact there. My goodness, Kimberly was attempting to move, nowhere to go. Nurul picks it up. She's in charge of that one, and again, plays it back. Here's Charmaine. This to level it, and in. It's getting louder by the minute, louder by the score. That's it. First quarter done and dusted. And you have to say, well, it's probably one of the best quarters of the week.
It is, or at least for today. I mean, it's really close. Nothing in it between the two teams. So it's, I think we might just have to watch to the last minute.
It's very exciting stuff here right now. And certainly Charmaine has been fantastic. The score, Singapore 11, Botswana 11. First quarter complete. So, 11 from 15, it should have been a little bit better for Singapore, 93%. We've got to be looking at around 80 to make any difference. And of course, Botswana, with their percentage there, have done really, really well. It's they haven't had as many chances, but what they've had, they've taken well.
Yes, John, they've definitely taken their opportunities. And Singapore would really need to just probably lift the goal percentages up a little bit. I mean, Charmaine's been doing well. We just need Pam to step up as well. And I'm sure she'll try to do that better in the second quarter.
It's been a pretty frenetic first quarter, though. There's been a lot of activity. And you can see the girls, but maybe not that shot there. But certainly earlier, there was a lot of heavy breathing going on, wasn't there? Because they put in a lot of effort.
Yeah, I'm sure that was a really tight quarter and nobody giving an inch. So I would imagine it will continue and carry on in the second and third.
Anyway, Ruth will be pretty happy with that. I mean, Singapore was behind for quite a significant period of that time, but they kept fighting back and found a way through. It was fantastic. Well, the crowd have really, really enjoyed it. They've come in their numbers here into the OCBC Arena, expecting to see Singapore perform. They would have preferred, obviously, to see them in the final. But this is for third and fourth place. And I guess if they can upset the form books and make that third place, that will be a big, big achievement. It's on the cards. It's going to be a close encounter, there's no question at all. The last time they met, it was 42-38 in favour of Botswana. But it's just showing the transition play from defence into attack, Singapore being very, very good at.
Yeah, actually, both teams have been very efficient and very clean and clinical. So hopefully we'll get to see more of that in the second quarter.
So Singapore in possession at the start of this second quarter. Oh, off the foot, and that didn't count? Okay, well, that's interesting.
Yeah, I thought so too. But hey, you just take your chances, right?
Yep. So, taking a bit of time to bring that ball forward. Now they find and pounce. Hilda moves again around the edge of the circle and then underneath the basket, and she picks it up right there. There you go. Not happy with that position, so, oh. Okay, that does count, but 12-11, Botswana.
Singapore will not be pleased to have lost that center pass.
Nope. Well, they had grounds for complaint of the way in which they lost it as well, so nothing from the coach to talk about. Hilda Binang, she's got it there right in the center. She doesn't miss them, I tell you. We've only counted one in the last quarter that she missed. Oh, and that was a poor pass. That was not good from Baizura Nurul. Baizura. It was shaping up. There was a great movement off the ball. The options were there, but she didn't find the target.
Yeah, it's about the connections. And that's really important in close affairs like this. Good take.
Some more excellent play. Good attack from Botswana. They're in the lead by three. Have the ball again, and this could be a big, big change here. Hilda picks it up. Long pass, and that beautiful work. Connection it was, and out of play, so they'll get another chance. Hilda will take the ball. Generally can do nothing about it. And, Vanessa Lee was trying to do something, couldn't make it.
Yeah, Chen Li Li has to really, you know, make sure she's disciplined and keep her distance, because, I mean, it's useless, you know, having a 1.96-meter tall goalkeeper standing by the side. So it's really just give a little bit more, just so that the umpires, you know, let up a bit as well.
Well, this is very, very unsatisfactory as far as Singapore's concerned at the start of the second half. 11 points they started with, they've still got the same margin. And here's another one. Hilda Binang is right there under the net, makes it easily, and that is now 16. So 16-11.
So Botswana have gone on a 5-0 run, and, you know, Singapore really needs to stop that. I mean, it's tightening up on defense, getting more man on man, which they did really well in the first quarter.
Quick hands, quick position. Bagidi's right there, plays it inside to Binang. Binang makes it. It's 17. Wow. Great start. And it all started with that suspicious little leg out.
Yeah.
Looking for opportunities here. Liu is not comfortable. She's not confident. I tell you, it happened time and again, and unfortunately, once more there, and I didn't mean to upset the ambition of Pamela Liu, but she is just... Oh, that's a good intercept. Unlucky. But it just shows, you know, if you do not have that confidence where you should have the confidence. I mean, that's a position, for goodness sake. She's the backup shooter. Come on.
I think sometimes, I mean, Pamela, while she's been in the team for a while, you know, she has always been a backup to Chen Huifen, who has retired. But then I think sometimes they over-rely on Charmaine, and, you know, you forget to take your shots sometimes, and it does affect your confidence sometimes.
Well, that's
too many sometimes, sorry.
No, it's okay. You're allowed to say that sometimes. Hilda off on foot, but it does again. She was a bit short on the shot, but it didn't matter. Look at the score, 18-11. It was 11-all at the first quarter. They've got the ball back again. Oh, well, that was an error. Maybe that will trigger something. Has got the shot after they make this one, though. Well, that will be another shot to Singapore. Well, it's certainly a possession, at least. Charmaine will be there. She's 3 metres back. Makes it. 18-12 at the moment, but it is Singapore's ball. It is Singapore from the center.
So there's an injury timeout. Singapore making a straight swap for Sheena Teo.
Okay. Singapore in possession, and well, that wasn't a replay. She didn't have the confidence to go for it. Charmaine is right there on target at 18. But they're giving up possession in the center. Good pressure, but Pamela again allows Botswana to continue with their attack. Hilda plays it off to Bagidi. Bagidi again plays it back, wing attack and center, very important around the circle, of course. 19-13, Singapore will now have a chance to close that deficit.
Nice patient build-up.
Yeah, it was. Good pass. Ooh, she had to watch the feet there. And Charmaine will turn and make this one, or attempt to. She does. She is unbelievably accurate, and it doesn't matter where on the court. Fantastic consistency. 14-19. That goal needed to be intercepted. Still some challenge. Unlucky, but there was contact, so it will be Botswana again. Hilda's got the ball. Sheena Teo there in attendance, but it doesn't make any difference. It will be Singapore's ball from the centre. She is a phenomenon, that cutaway of the goal shooter for Botswana. Well, it's been a little bit of a disastrous start to this second quarter for Singapore, but they can make amends, make this one, and that's a confidence booster.
Yes, that was probably important for Pamela Liu.
Singapore do fight well, and they have been known to come back from very difficult positions, but 21-15 with just 7 minutes left in the half. It's a difficult position. The Australian referee is doing a good job there. They're hugely talented. There you go.
Good drive to the top of the circle by Kimberly Lim. I mean, that's where you want to feed from, at the edge of the goal circle.
Now, this will be a really good time to try and get back possession. A turnover here will be absolutely vital.
Great take. Yes,
yeah. Hilda's missed it, but she gets another chance. Does she? No! Oh, my goodness. Now, that was a good turnover. They've got the centre pass to come. Six minutes left in the half. That's a good play. Charmaine gets into great shape, turns beautifully. Lovely shot, and they've got possession again. Excellent work. 17-21. This to bring it back within three. Good, hard driving in for that ball. It needed it. Oh, well, it was in the center circle, so that's okay. When you hear the whistle, you just go, oh, what was that about?
Yeah, you panic for a little while, and then you're like, oh, that's fine, that's an hours. Oh, that's a rare miss.
Well, she's got... she is human, there's no question about that. She's done so well, but at 81%, is she? 80%, actually, overall. Charmaine is still top of the list in Singapore. And again, some contact. Hilda's there. She finishes. That's 22-17. What a shame. The last Singapore attack was not successful, because that's given the Botswana team huge impetus. Momentum is all what it's about, and there's a changeover, is it? No, it's not. Okay.
So that's obstruction by both players.
Oh, right, okay. Hilda again, she's tall enough to make a difference, and makes the point for 23. It's gone from 3-6 now. That's better. That's much better, but wants to play it back around. That makes it much easier to defend, doesn't it? Much easier. Well done, Charmaine. Chumli Lee on the sidelines there. Just hoping for a really good finish to this half. It's not going to happen, is it? Yes, it may be. Wow. Still, oh no, it's going to be Singapore's ball, is it, or not?
Yes, it's Singapore's ball.
It is.
Good intercept by vice captain Baizua.
Yeah. That's a nice. She ran away well to pick that up. That was good work by Pamela. Pamela's in position, but now, again, Baizua is having to use the line, the circle line, in order to get an advantage. But I tell you what, the defenders are working well for Botswana.
Yeah, they are. They're really trying to keep the shooters away from the post and the mid-court away from the goal circle, so it's really hard to feed.
Very tough. Those defenders for Botswana are not just big, but they are very, very good in anticipation. Pamela, you've got to take it. No? Okay. Come on, Charmaine, make it. Good girl. Yeah, but that is the nervous moments, isn't it? And they will not be happy with that. Okay, it was a score, but the fact is they're relying on Charmaine so much. Now, come on, you can't pass that one off. Oh, dear, dear. Well, there's not much to be said except, wow.
It is really quite important to have to share the shooting load, as we call it, you know, just to make sure you keep the defenders guessing. Good take by Hilda.
Yeah, fantastic take. Brilliant take and a good point. They deserve that one. 24-19. Just over 2 minutes gone. They've got possession again. The alternate centre. Oi!
A wee bit late by Sheena Teo, but you know.
What a good attempt. Yeah, Hilda's right there, just that half a step, and she's right at it. This is disappointing for the hosts, but 25-19. It's still not irretrievable. They can come back into it with a couple of turnovers. And oh!
Yeah, but that's not what you need. Little mistakes will cost you.
Long pass, too long. Single-handed pass, the fastest in the game. Of course, it's pushed like that. Another single-handed, much better, more accurate. Lob pass, bounce pass, no. Comes to chest, but it's lucky to get that one back. Now, this will certainly be 90% in.
81% in.
81% in, I love it. Isn't that great? This is going to be 81% in. Yeah, here's a turnover.
Great defense.
Not a lot of time left in this one. 33 seconds. Singapore got a chance to make one. Who's got possession after it?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Hopefully it's Singapore.
I won't ask you the question ever again.
I'll pay more attention next quarter. Okay.
Well, there's not much time left in it. That's why I'm asking. 12 seconds. Come on, let's get the shot in and on with the next phase. Here we go, 10 seconds left. Here we have one in, there you go. Who's got the next? It's going to be Singapore. That's why I was hoping. 3, 2, 1, shoot it in. No, come on. Let's get it in. Here we go. Pamela, it's all on you. Oh, dear. Well, Singapore have had its chances. There's no question about that. They've played well in between the lines, but I'm afraid around the circle it's all been Charmaine they've relied on, and at the other end Hilda has also relied on Tumisang Bagidi to help her out. So that has been the story, I'm afraid, and it's all, when you talk about performances, Pamela has just not performing, she's lost her confidence, and which means she's always looking for Charmaine to bail her out. It's half time at the moment. Singapore are behind. But I have to say, not an impossible position, but it will be a thrilling match-up if they do come back into this.
Yeah, it's only a four-point game, and that is, what, 2 center passes that you need to turn over? So definitely doable for Singapore.
There you go. Half-time then. Singapore 21, Botswana 25. It's all to play for in the second half. There were lots of positives in the Singapore performance in that first half. The big positive was Charmaine's very, very good performance. Excellent performance. There were a couple of disappointments, but Charmaine certainly wasn't one of them. She came up time and time again with some excellent play. But the big problem was at the other end, Hilda Binang, together with Bagidi, were in sensational form. And here is the captain. Bagidi makes it there. But Hilda, again, only missed one in the first half. An extraordinary performance. Here we go. Passing it off to Bagidi once more, but no problems once they get into that very dangerous position. Bagidi again, really great take with the jump finish. Pamela struggled. Watch out. That's the one that she got. That was what you'd hoped would continue to give her confidence. But it was left basically to Charmaine to make those all-important finishes. We've got 8 minutes between the first and second half, and we're just picking up some of the highlights here of the match. But the stats here, the score is 21-25, and the percentages have dropped off the cliff. What do you think?
Well, I mean, while the percentages are lower, they just need to keep trying, you know. I mean, get more attempts, you know, put in more shots. Maybe work yourself nearer to the post is something that, you know, Singapore could work towards. But look at that amazing Botswana stats, 93%.
That is extraordinary. That's Hilda Binang together with Bagidi. And, of course, Pamela, and I know we've said it during the commentary itself, but that confidence is so, so important. And it's missing at the minute. Maybe the second half will be different, and maybe this is where the coach comes into it, because if you can put an arm around Pamela and say, hey, come on, we know you can do better, it's going to certainly make a difference. But Chun Li Lee there, just we're going past her, but I know that the coach is having a chat now to Pamela at the other end.
So yes, it will be interesting to see if both teams make some changes. Singapore might have some changes lined up, because from where we sit, I peeped a few changes. So we'll look out for that in the third quarter.
Ruth Aitken's got a really lovely demeanor, hasn't she? You know, she's got a ready smile there. And, you know, when you're struggling a little bit, sometimes you need that motherly approach, don't you?
Yeah, she's really encouraging. And yeah, you're right. Sometimes it's just a kind word to say, come on, you can do better. And you are better than that. So let's hope she pushes the girls a bit.
Well, I don't know the precise stat, but in my head, I got a feeling that Pamela has missed about four, and that is the difference in the score. But they cannot feel comfortable and confident right yet. There's certainly a long way to go in this match, and I have every confidence that Singapore, playing at home, can find something in the second half. We will see. Time will tell. But the crowd are certainly giving them huge support, and I believe that they have the potential to come back. The youngsters there from ANZA, New Zealand, of course, Australia, New Zealand, amongst the finest players in the world. So very, very important that they keep their interest. Well, Singapore just preparing now. Charmaine going into goal attack. Josephine Yeo into wing defence. And goal shooter, Mei Ling. Come on, tell me, what do you think? So it wasn't actually the motherly approach, hand on shoulder stuff in the end. It was a change.
Yeah, I guess, I mean, what's the risk in, you know, using new people? And then it's a good learning experience, I think, for Pamela as well. You know, maybe she just needs to sit out for one quarter. Maybe she'll come back again. But then it's a great opportunity for Mei Ling. She's been doing really well all week. So I'm looking forward to seeing what she can bring to the game.
Well, Mei Ling's stats are 81.36%, 48 from 59. So you never know. I think that was a really good move, because there's no point putting a rabbit in front of the headlights time and time again. It's going to be, it was pressure. And okay, I gave a bit of criticism, but you know, I mean, she's the one out there, and she's the one that everyone is expecting to perform. So Yu Meiling takes over. Now, what's the difference between goal shooter and goal attack then, in terms of what their duties are?
So, I mean, for Mei Ling, I mean, besides the physical areas that you could play, so for a goal shooter, you can only play in one third of the court, whereas goal attack, you do two thirds. But then you are sort of like the last man standing, and everyone is coming towards you, and you know your job is to, you know, finish what was delivered.
Right, here we go. Third quarter underway. 4 points the lead for Botswana. And they have possession, by obviously the fact that they took the centre ball. Yeah, some good chasing around, some good attempts to break it, and that is going at, okay, Botswana again, but once more, that defensive zone is really being policed very nicely by the Singapore girls. Forcing a long ball. Ooh, that was a little bit lucky for Bagidi to pick up, but here's Hilda, she's in her favourite position, and it's short. That's the second time she's missed out, but they're lucky to get that one back. Lucky to get it back, and it's still again gone, but Bagidi's right there. Well, that just shows that's not just luck, actually. It's good body positioning,
yeah,
isn't it? And that's very good.
It is good rebound position. So first shot for Yu Meiling.
Oh, my goodness. She's got a second chance. Reprieve. Reprieve. Hooray.
Always nice to, you know, get your first shot done and dusted.
And once again, once you know it is your partner in attack that's doing it, then it takes a little bit of pressure off Charmaine as well. Right, now, here's a a really important attack. They've got to make this one stick. They cannot afford to go back behind in this third quarter, any further behind. Well, that was a replay, wasn't it?
That was short pass. Short pass, yes. So you do need to allow a defender, though they don't specify what, how big or small that defender is, to pass between the passer and the catcher.
Yeah, it's strange that, because that wasn't even a pass or a catch. It was just a little roll on the floor, wasn't it? Okay, well, that was good. Good transition. Lovely movement forward by Botswana. And we have to admire that team because, you know, they have been they've been consistent in their movement. They're defending with strength and they're making the big, big turnovers count. Okay, a little bit too hard for Hilda. Nicely played out of defense. Singapore looking for options here. There's some good play.
So good defense by Botswana.
They are really slowing
down the ball.
Yeah, filling the gaps. Filling the gaps very, very quickly. Kimberly. And then
it's short again. Singapore really needs to, I mean, unfortunately, the umpire calls for things and you have to adjust to the umpire's point of view. So if they know that that's, you know, consistently viewed as short, you really just have to lengthen the pass.
Yep. Yeah, that's really good. Strong pass, great positioning. Hilda misses though, but it's still Botswana's ball.
Quite surprising. I think she's missed
three now. Yep. Oh.
She really needs to get off Hilda's back and move her feet a little bit more. Because I mean, as long as you're stuck to the back, there's not much you can really take off Hilda.
I don't think we've had a three-second whistle, have we?
No, not yet.
Hey, have you ever been through a match where there's never been a three-second? Cool. It's unusual, very unusual.
Yeah.
But obviously, it just shows that there's a lot of effort and energy going on out there. There's a lot of movement off the ball. Bagidi's got it. And that will be 30-23. That's a big gap now to try to close.
So the timing between the defenders and the attackers now is slightly off, I think, because, you know, Singapore is passing back quite a bit.
Yu Mei Ling once more, and she makes it for 24. They will have, Botswana will have the center pass now. Oh, that's a good attempt to defend, but Botswana will pick it up. Bagidi takes it, and oh no, what was that?
It looks like a short pass. That's what the umpire showed. Yeah.
Wow, that's harsh, isn't it? Singapore suffered from the same decision just earlier. But they're obviously being consistent, and that's... what they decided, there's umpires panel here as well, supporting. Umpires advisory panel. So they've obviously made this decision.
I think as long as your umpires are consistent, that's, you know, to both teams, I mean, that's all you can ask for.
Yeah. So 25-30. And possession. Oh, dear. Oh, a little lucky. They're very, very fast in defense, the Botswana team.
Yes, they are.
They can really track you down very quickly. Lovely bounce pass. Good work. Okay, here's Charmaine from 3 meters and in. 26. 26-30. And the scoreboard can put pressure on itself. Botswana will feel... Botswana will feel Singapore creeping up that board. Nice play. Now let's make this one count. Again, it will be Singapore's ball on the edge. Again, it's Nehru. Chance here. Well, you will turn, but it's gone back again. Easy to Kimberly, then to Charmaine. Charmaine will have another free shot here. And has made it. Again, she has got a peculiar shot. The style of the shot is, but it's so effective. The backspin that comes on it, as long as it goes deep enough onto the rim, it will come back into the basket, that's for sure. But it's a fantastic, consistent shot. There's the one that's missed. Ouch. That is a big ouch. Needed that.
Needed that to Len.
Botswana just waiting for a little bit of support. There it is. It comes. Nicely played. Good left-hand pass. She's a very talented lady, I have to say. Saw her here last year as well. Very, very good. Okay, that will be in and counting. 31-27. But Shelametsi is the name of the girl that I was talking about just now. And she's so, so fast. Moves beautifully.
So this is good work by Singapore, trying to hold up the ball.
Hilda's there, plays it outside again. Bagidi, and a bit of hipping action there.
Contact.
Contacto.
With the hips.
With the hips. Hey, five misses this this time. Oh. Miss Tio would have been penalized if she hadn't have scored that.
So there's a medical timeout, I think.
Oh.
So we'll see.
Center, I think it was. I think it's Chetsa Machaba. Chetsa Machaba comes off. And, well, there is another several centers. That Sele Selametsi. Singapore giving up possession here at 26-32. They can't afford to do any more. There's a lot of effort going into this match, I tell you. There's a lot of energy out on that court. Bagidi again lays it off and then is up for the shot and makes it. But, well, this is now getting to the stage where it's getting very serious for Singapore. 33-27.
Botswana's passes are just amazing to watch. You know, they're quick, they're fast, they're accurate. It's just really entertaining.
Yep, 34-27. The crowd is still trying to keep the Singapore team busy and buzzing, but it's getting increasingly difficult. Yeah, that's good play. Okay, Charmaine will turn and after the pass and makes this one. Good stuff. 27-34. Less than 5 minutes left in this third quarter. Botswana have done a really good job. They've upset the rhythm of Singapore. They've defended brilliantly. They've intercepted when they possibly can with the turnovers. But the most important thing is they are in so close attendance in the defensive positions. That was another mistake. Really good play. Okay, it is a very important attack developing here for Singapore, because if they can score from here, they get the next possession at the center pass. Singapore still coming on the attack, and again, because she's been freed up a little bit, a goal attack, Charmaine So has just got a little bit more movement. They are so quick to tie her down, though. Just look at those defending duo. That Botswana defending duo are really, really aggressive. Good stuff. 29-34. They got possession. This to make it 30 if they possibly can right here. Oh, it's off the post and they're still in play. Botswana pick it up. That was poor piece of build up there, though. Oh, lovely. Good work.
Nice pick up.
Yeah. Charmaine's got it back and's got it in. Closing down tactics now, then. What do you reckon?
I think I still would like to see more shooting from the Singapore, well, now it's goal shooter. In previous quarter, it was goal attack. I mean, while you could, Charmaine is putting in most of the shots, but then it's really, I feel, an over-reliance on her. But Hilda has totally gone off the ball.
Well, yeah, she gets that in, but that was her sixth miss. 35, 30. Oh, dear. No, oh, it's nice.
It's
oh,
step.
Traveling.
Yeah.
But it was very nice pick up, but then ruined it with an extra step. Long pass is good. And then the error on the play, that is no good. Wow. That's frustrating. Shinichiro, or was it, no, Vanessa, was it? Agidi's right here, makes it 36-30. This is going to be a tough, tough situation to come back from now, especially with the possession.
That's a nice shove by Charmaine.
Shoving Charmaine, not champagne.
Good try by Shino Kyo.
Yeah. Well done. From distance, she found it a bit easier. 37-30. Putting the ball into space, into the area that you're working to. She's got to shoot that one and she makes a mess of it. Well, that's certainly been the problem, but good intercept. No, not quite. There was a touch.
Yeah, good attempt by Josephine. Yeah. You read it well, but unfortunately just ran out of space.
Good defense there. They've got a chase for it, though. Oh, there was a reticence to go. That was really unlucky because Nurul was in great position. And that is it. The third quarter is complete. Are they going to get one more shot? No,
yep.
They will. Okay. Yeah, well played. 38-30. And that is probably, as far as Singapore's concerned, that's probably going to be a step too far, I would think. 8 points in the final quarter?
Oh, you'd be surprised. I think, how fast the game goes these days. And then mistakes, as long as you need just a couple of mistakes to creep in, and that's all you need. So still in with a shot, I feel.
Well, that's good news. Pearline Chan, former captain of Singapore. Let's have the scoreboard then for the third quarter in just a couple of moments. It's 30 points to Singapore, 38 to Botswana. It will be a tough, tough ask, but we will certainly be positive and be shouting and screaming for a really good fourth quarter. So here we have the sats then. A little sadness creeps into the air here. 30-38. 30 from 41, that's a 73%. We're going lower and lower. As a team, we need to get a little bit higher than that, that's for sure. But Botswana have been consistent. They're very, very fast in attack. Their defense has been very excellent. In fact, if you talk about pressurizing in defense, I think they're the epitome of it. They've just done so well, Pauline.
Yeah, they're really quick and then quite tight as well. So it has been a challenge for Singapore to really penetrate and, you know, get the ball to their shooters.
Does that mean, the fact that she's on her feet, does that mean she may be coming back on to court? Chun Li.
Judging by that, I don't think so. Sheena Teo has been doing quite well, I think. You know, she's been quite aggressive. She's moving her feet a lot more compared to the previous quarter that she was on.
Well, Singapore with their final moments now. We're going up to the final quarter. And, well, has the team changed a huge amount, Pauline?
Yes, so Singapore has just made one change. They're bringing in Parvin Nair again, wing defense for the first quarter. So she's back on and Josephine Teo goes to the bench.
Parvin Nair, wing defense. And again, immediately, the warning signals are out. Botswana on the attack. And the two dynamic players, there they are. Hilda is right there. And misses another one, and it's immediate turnover. Wow. From a position of total control, that's a nice little switch there. So that will be Charmaine Soh's come out on the edge of the circle, plays it off again. And now is in the position to shoot from distance and misses that one. Oh dear. Well, she took over from goal attack, in the position of goal attack from goal shooter. But maybe that was an instance when it could have just come back off to the goal, the now goal shooter, Yu Meiling.
So good pressure by goalkeeper Sheena Teo. Really, you know, making Hilda work hard just to get the ball.
Yeah, you get the impression it's now or never for Singapore. They've still got 13 and a half minutes to go in the match, but need to really, really sharpen. And that's another error, but lucky to get it back. Charmaine, one more chance. Makes it. 31-39. Now, the big challenge is how to get the ball back.
One at a time.
Yeah. Look at that. It's a big, big, long pass. That's how to get it back.
Yeah.
Put pressure on the central attackers. Suddenly they lose their patience.
And then it's just about converting every chance that you get.
Nope, no good. Great piece of defending, lovely anticipation, long arms.
Very long.
Again, Shelametsi is always there, working the plays. Oh, great work.
Great intercept. Yeah.
Yeah, that brought the crowd alive. Oy, a little bit of a push. We will have that from the side. Kimberly Lim is quite amused by that. 31-39. This is a must convert here. Charmaine will take half a pace, full pace forward, and then makes it.
39-32 with a centre pass to come.
Good. That's really good. Excellent. Should have gone. Okay, we'll have another chance here on the outside. Good. Yeah, she was confident there. You could feel it. She
knew. You could see it.
Yep, absolutely. 33-39. Brought forward for an infringement at the top third. They call it the transverse line, is it?
Yes, they do. Mm-hmm.
Scrambling for the ball, Hilda ends up with it, and she's got an even closer opportunity, which she makes, and that is now 40-33. Singapore have got to make every chance count now. They can't afford to lose out at all. Mei Ling has got the chance there, but it will be Charmaine to take the shot. And it's in, it's 34. Turnover now would be a super, super moment. Oop. And a little error.
Oh, that was just bad luck.
Unlucky, yeah. Sinametsi again gets it in. And it will be Begidi who plays it back off. Oh. Hilda running across the bottom, below the net beautifully, well found. 41-34. Yeah, Kimberly does well, into passing there with Charmaine, who makes it 35. Bing. Singapore desperately needs a turnover. Just under, well, it's 9.5 minutes left in the match. It's going to be an opportunity for Begidi. She takes half a pace forward. She is out of the play. And that is Singapore's. This is an opportunity. Big one. Good passing.
Yeah, Singapore really needs to convert this one if they want to draw closer and really push the match.
Yu Meiling has made it. 36. 36-41 with the possession now from the center. That's great work. That's very, very attractive play. Charmaine's here for 37. She makes it! And again, the crowd getting fairly excited here. One more turnover and it could be all squared. This is a big fight back. 8 points the deficit in the start of the fourth quarter. And just listen to the crowd.
It is. It's just one more intercept. And I think the momentum would have swung.
8 minutes left. Still lots of time to go. Some really good marking required. Ooh, that was close. Even better, even better. And it's a foul against the defender, against the attacker. It will be Singapore's ball. Tio picks it up. We've got that turnover. Let's see whether or not we can get it through to the line now with big excitement. Watch out for the 3 seconds. It's not happened yet. Lovely bounce pass and another feed. Mei Ling is there. Mei Ling puts it up and it's in the basket! 38-41.
We've got a match on hand.
It was worth coming, wasn't it, this afternoon? You knew you were going to get entertainment. Here she goes again. Lim's there, So's there. So is up and she will make. Charmaine makes another one! 39-41 and this is sensational stuff. What a fight back. 6 points the difference in this fourth quarter. Just listen to the crowd. They want another intercept. They want another turnover right now.
And that's when, you know, the crowd really plays a part. They're like the eighth man.
And there it is! It will be Singapore's ball. Singapore have got it from defence. Here they come. Long passing. Good passing. Who's in the middle there? And another one. Mei Ling is there. Within 1 point now. No, it's short. Oh, dear. Took the concentration of the focus. That is such a shame because that could have given us a huge, dramatic end to this match. It still could happen yet, of course. Vergidi is there. Plays it off once more. Centre and wing attack involved in this one all the time. Here's Vergidi again. She will make this. She's got it. 42-39 with Botswana in possession. Oh, no, it is Singapore's. Gee, that makes such a difference, doesn't it? Last point from Yu Mei Ling. Wow, right, we get our breath back a little bit here now. Singapore keeping the possession and the ambition on. That's in. Oh, what a great, remarkable turnover that was. Botswana have again thwarted the ambition of Singapore. And that will be Hilda's free shot. It's in, it's 43. Gosh, after all that real excitement, you can see the bench there for Botswana getting very, very involved.
Yeah, it looks like that might be the defining moment. Okay, that's a scuffle going on. I wonder who will come out on top.
Kimberly thinks it should have been her.
It was quite close. Great looking, great vision.
Yeah. Well, for 10 seconds, Singapore looked like they had a real, real chance. Less than 5 minutes to go, and once again, the gap is five. We need to mop up, or is it? Yeah, it is a mop up.
Just from the scuffle minute ago, Kimberly.
And just like the good lady she is, Kimberly does the housework as well as make the mess. You know about that with two sons, don't you?
Yeah, I'm constantly telling them to clean up their mess.
Singapore, you can give us a lot of entertainment right here by putting this one in. Uh-oh. And then... Oh, my goodness.
That is replay because she basically,
got repossessed. No, it's still Botswana. You can't blame her, though. It was a great effort. Look at the heavy breathing there. My goodness, they're putting a huge effort in. Well, it was all going to give us such a dramatic finish. Yu Mei Ling couldn't convert a fairly simple opportunity. That is Singapore's ball. Are we going to see a twist yet? Could be a final twist. Parveen moves it into the center, and again Kimberly is trying to give us an advantage here underneath that post. That was very similar to an earlier incident where Singapore lost possession and lost the point, but they've got a second opportunity here. It will be Charmaine to make it 40. There it is. It's Botswana's restart, though. Now we need some intercept. We need some really, really keen defending without fouling.
Yes, because there's just 3 minutes left. And the difference is four.
Okay, Bagidi's there. She may lay it off. She doesn't need to lay it off. 45-40.
Bagidi has just been a model of consistency.
Very good. Oh, that's a poor shot. A poor pass, rather. Here's the good shot. Hilda gets it in, 46-40, and suddenly the opportunity, the chance, it was there, it was a glint in the eye, and suddenly it was totally killed by Botswana's play. still in possession. 2 minutes, just a little over 2 minutes left. He's going to lay it off now. Begidi again. You said the model of perfection. Well, that was missed. It will be Singapore's ball, I think. No, it's not. It Botswana. Came off a Singapore defender, so it will be Botswana. Hilda's there. Hilda Binang has got it. 47-40. Wow, what a reversal. Singapore's ball. It's been highly entertaining, there's no question about that. We've had a lot to scream and shout about, a lot to get excited about, and really good play. Both sides, all girls have put on a great show.
Yeah, it has been, and you know, there was like a minute or two where Singapore really had a chance.
Yeah, the pressure was on, and Botswana made a couple of errors. Kimberly just pushing it back in for Charmaine to be short. No, it's Yuling, sorry. Yu Meiling to attempt once again, but those crucial times. She missed that one to put it back in reachable one-point difference. Didn't happen. And that won't happen. Less than a minute left, you can see, 40 seconds on the clock. The clock has stopped for the moment, but it will run down very quickly. The crowd will be able to shout and scream in just a moment to give you the final times. Oh, there's
great
a turnabout.
Reading of the game.
27. 22 now. Singapore will have a time has been called out for the moment. Parveen gets us into play, and then it is straight across. Meiling has made that one. Oh dear, 41 points, but that will be probably the last score of this particular matchup. The Hooter is ready to go.
And Botswana is happy to just play the ball
around.
Happy
to play it around. There we go. But they've actually done the business and really successfully. This for 48, and there you go. It won't count.
It won't count. But Botswana will be very pleased with their efforts
today.
They
will be delighted with that today, because for the second time in this Nations Cup tournament, they have beaten the host nation, Singapore. And in fact, have increased their score over Singapore. Last time, on the second day of the competition, they won by 4 points. It was better than that this time around. Chen Li Li congratulates. She had a part to play in the early part of the matchup, but ultimately Singapore drops back into fourth place in the competition. And well, they will be disappointed, but a really entertaining match.
It has been. I mean, both teams will be quite pleased with what they've put out today. I think, you know, there were many, many good patches of play. So that's something to take away from this match.
And the camaraderie, of course, that is on show right there. You know all about that. It's a very important part of the netball scene, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not just about the games. You know, after that's all finished, you become friends, you enjoy a good night of eating and drinking. So that should be something that the girls should look forward to as well.
Hilda gets the bumps, but I tell you, she missed a few in that second half, but throughout the tournament, she's been sensational.
She has been. She has been right up there with the best of the lot. I mean, 80% in general, like what more could you ask for?
And the captain also, Tumisang Bagidi, taking a ride on the back of her colleague as well. I guess overall you'd have to say that Ruth Aitken would be fairly pleased with that performance.
Yeah, I mean, considering Ruth has a fairly new team, I mean, she had quite a number of retirements from Pamela Hirobalan, Mickey Lin and Chen Huifeng. So to get the opportunity to put the girls out there and to do, I mean, relatively well, she should be pleased.
So, well, it's just remaining now for the final decision to be made. But before that, here is the final score then of the third, fourth placing. Singapore 41, Botswana 47. And it's third place to Botswana, fourth to Singapore. So, Singapore started well enough. And of course, Charmaine So came up as expected with some fabulous shots, her traditional little applauding herself at the moment of success. There you go, clap again, why not? Big smile as well that time. But at the other end, of course, it was the duo on the attack. The Hilda and again the captain, Tumisang Bagidi, who did such damage, pushed the score out ahead to 8 points at one stage. And there, once again, Bagidi does the business underneath the net. And of course, the diminutive Shelametsi, the wing attack, is always featuring in there somewhere. Three there in a row for Bagidi. Singapore did their best. Pamela, yeah, she makes that one. That was very important, but she was substituted at half time, of course, because she missed quite a number. Charmaine comes in and delivers once again, but it was not to be. We now moves on in the match, and Hilda, well, she was very, very consistent throughout the tournament. Missed a few during this match. Thank goodness she did, otherwise Singapore would have lost by a lot more. But as it happens, Yu then came on. Yu Mei Ling came on in the second half. She made some significant moments. But the crucial time when Singapore came back within 2 points, Yu Mei Ling had an opportunity and I'm afraid failed to take it. And that was the signal for Botswana to take over full control of the final moments. I've got a feeling this might even be it. No, that was a successful one by Mailing. But very good movement, and again a good feed by Shelametsi. And they were just too strong. Charmaine did well, no question. But ultimately, it's only small moments that make the difference. That was a lovely little dummy bend of the knees which caused the problems, and there Bagidi comes up again and converts. Botswana were just too strong in the end. And they're being interviewed right now. Bagidi is right there. Here are the stats. 41 out of 56. And again, that 73% is not quite good enough in the overall match. And of course, 80%, that went down a bit because of those misses by Hilda, but still well enough to get across the line. It was close. It was much closer than the score suggests.
Yeah, it was. There were many times where the lead could have changed hands, but then, yeah, unfortunately, at the end, I think it was the shooting percentages that mattered. And but that is just also a good learning opportunity for the Singapore shooters.
I mean, it was. So the president, we'll see her a little bit in a while. She was just having a word with Ruth there, but okay. The final score then was in favour of Botswana. So Botswana take third place in the tournament.